Hello everybody, hope you guys are having a good day today. So, just to give you an idea of what we're going to do today, I'm going to change the spark plugs on my Mustang. It's a 2012 Mustang GT, and yeah, it's just one of those things you need to do every so often. It's kind of like preventative maintenance. I'm not preventative, but general maintenance. So, yep. That's what we're going to do today. You're going to want to start to basically make sure you have enough clearance to kind of get to everything. So I'm going to start by taking the strut tower brace off. This is a 13 millimeter socket. You can use a regular 3/8 ratchet, half inch ratchet, quarter inch ratchet. Well, I wouldn't recommend a quarter inch ratchet, but you can do it if you need to. I do this because, well, it's faster. All right. Now this is gonna be specific to my car. However, it can be quite general when it comes to doing spark plugs. So you can kind of apply this to any car. But for me, I'm going to have to move this PVC stuff, or PCB, sorry. Together. And I'll be going through and doing a video overview of what all I have done to this car for you guys. At some point here. Ooh, that's oil. So these are oil catch cans, and what they do is catch these oil vapors that are sent back through and stop them from going back up into the intake. It's meant to just kind of help cut down on some of the crud that gets up inside the intake. So you don't have to do so much maintenance when it comes to cleaning and maintaining it, because cleaning intake, well, it's not easy. That's just to get these bolts down here all. I'm just gonna basically bust on these and then leave it be. That one. Oh man. So that's cool. Just gonna do that, wedge it out of the way a little bit. And now I gotta find my freaking socket. Oh, that wasn't so bad. Right there, guys. Not too big of a deal. Just, you know, be careful. I hope that doesn't happen to you if you decide to pursue this job. And it's not gonna be that big of a deal. It's not that difficult of a job. I'm no beginner, but I'm also no expert, so. Apparently, I really had them on there. Make sure they're nice and loose. I'm gonna set this down here this time. And I'm just gonna slowly pull this up as to catch those nuts to keep them from going anywhere else. And as a rule of thumb, you can try and group your nuts together. So hopefully, you know, help you remember where they all came from. Alright, we're just gonna set this over here. And bam, And bam! At this point, we can just start to pull these valve covers off. Very simple to do. We just pop in, pop out. And bam! Sorry, I apologize if I do that a lot. Now, like I said before, I want to pull this oil cap off, give yourself proper clearance. Pick that up. Oop, don't lose it. And then put the oil cap back on, just because you want to keep that closed. What are you doing, Skyler? As to prevent anything from possibly getting up in the oil. Obviously, your filter kind of filters whatever gets in there out, but you still want to, do what you can to protect it. And so now, just gonna pop these clips up one by one and pull them off. So you push down, so you slide up to clamp it, and you push down, which releases the little clip so that it can slide up. Just kind of tuck them out of the way. Like so. Hopefully they have a, That was already in clip. Just be careful, you don't want to try and yank too hard and mess anything up. It looks like maybe a 10 now. Or an 8. That's an 8. Socket here. Now, one thing I will say is you'll see me power these off, but I will never power them on. What I'm going to do these one by one as well. And here, now it's loose, it's going to slide right out. You do want to inspect your coils, kind of look them over, make sure everything looks okay, don't have any oil or anything like that. Let's see. Just gonna go around and clean it off a little bit. Why? Because I said so. Necessary? Not particularly. Alright. And then I'm gonna guess maybe 14, 15, something like that. For spark plugs, you're gonna wanna have a deep socket. Have special sockets for spark plugs. I don't particularly like them. It seems like anytime I use them, they don't really do what they're supposed to do. So I just finesse it. So I'm gonna start with the 14. Yeah, that feels. Gonna need an extension to get down in there properly. Not feeling anything. It's probably too small. I've never done spark plugs on this car before, in case you can't tell. 16 ago. There we go. I don't really like that length. I'm gonna come over here and use my wobbly one. Get a little bit of play. No, I'm not gonna use the impact to get these spark plugs out. Just because I don't really like to hit it that hard. Do your hands, you know. Watch this. Yep, and I'm just gonna loosen them and see what you're doing. Does look like it's free. So, I'm going to show you my trick to getting spark plugs out. I don't know why I didn't have this out already. I knew I was doing spark plugs. And just like that, spark plugs out. So, I'm not sure if you can see this, but I guess it is. That's perfect. There's dirt coming off of it. But it doesn't look to be oil. It looked a little wet, so that's why I wanted to do that. But, yeah, alright. That's why we're replacing them! Yay! New spark plugs! Woo! Do plan to supercharge, so that's why I'm not worried about putting in my spark plug for now. So we're just gonna kind of slowly, well, or just drop it. Say hello to the internet.
Hi, internet.
And oh shit, I didn't put the fucking. Almost forgot. You guys like my technique of getting it in the hole? Yeah, I know. Oh god. What I always do is I always keep the old spark plugs, just put them in the new box. Just saying, it's what I do. You don't have to. Let me go grab some anti-seize. So, when I'm doing spark plugs, the rule of thumb is to get some anti-seize lubricant. You're going to want to put that on the threads of said spark plug. It just helps it for when you go to take them out so that they don't seize up in the inside of the block or the head there. Make it difficult to do some maintenance on your car. And like I said, we're just gonna slowly put it back down in there. Oh, okay. That's not slowly. Oh, I didn't even check the gap. Some of them. I forgot to check the gap. Oh my god. What, for gapping? Yeah, I have one. So, rule of thumb when you replace spark plugs, you want to make sure that they're set at the proper gap. My specific application, I believe, calls for 0.4, like 4 to 4.6 basically. So basically 0.45. So we've got a spark plug tool here. And you're going to start with the thin end and just kind of go around until it catches. And it's that point. Whoop. It's a little high. So it's at like 4.7, 0.47 right there. 2.4 and then just all the hashes. And to tighten it, or you know, tighten the gap, you just push it down a little bit. Oh, the vacuum leak. You know, I've never really gotten that like fixed, but I replaced like the entire line and it still didn't go away, so I've just decided that it's gonna be. Because it's not like I'm throwing any check engine lights or anything like that. God damn it, I gotta lower that a little quick, shorter. Or slower. Huh? Yeah, I hate those things, though. They don't ever work for me. I have them. I just don't like to use them. Yep. Yep, so you're just going to want to make sure it feels okay. If you have any resistance going on when you're tightening it down, just kind of stop. Make sure that, that you're not cross-threading it. And so you just kind of want to get it to where it's hand tight, and then I believe it's like an eighth of a turn, quarter turn, so to right here, because they have little crush washers on them, I believe, so eighth of a turn, right there. Yeah, probably. Well, yeah, just keep doing that, please. Balancer torque. Pretty sure I did a little more than that just now. Oh well. Yeah. So if you can find your torque specs and torque them down properly, do so. However, I did not, because I am somewhat lazy.
Good.
Yep. So at this point, spark plug's in, feels nice and tight, got your anti-seize on there. You're just going to put the coil pack back over the spark plug. And take your bolt. Remember what I said is I do not power down, only power out. Because if you do have it accidentally cross-threaded, you don't want to sit there and force it down. That's my other neighbors. I'm pretty sure it's a drug house, but I'm just saying. I don't know that. What do you say? House spritz wrong by slot. Yeah. Well, I'm waiting a day, man. So this one, I'm just gonna tighten down until it feels pretty good. Put this over here, ready to go. From here. Now that I've gone fumbled through all the other steps, it should be smooth sailing. And once you've got it reinstalled, you can just slide this back down, pop that shut, keeps it from coming loose. Then from here you just rinse.
Elizabeth, check this out.
sorry if I hurt you, but this time I'm not waiting around. Who will admire you when the fire inside of you is burying 6 feet?
Almost done, y'all. Oh no. But I don't wanna. No. That's not the right way to do it, but fuck it. That would take me way too much time to get the battery and the fucking battery side on off. Well, folks, I don't recommend this at home. Nope, we're good. Just gonna drop that in like that. Come in behind it. Alright, that's how you know it's on there. Ta-da! Not the particularly recommended way of going about it, unless you got the tools, but it'll get her done. That one was relatively easy too. So weird. I'm like, okay, is one side running, or was one side running worse than the other, or what?
Well, they're not supposed to loosen up over time, should they?
Well, I don't think it loosened up over time. I'm just saying, I don't think it was torqued down as hard, or I don't know what, but what's she doing? Oh, here's the predicament. All sketchy as fuck. Now I'm scared. I think I melted it to it. Fuck. Yeah. I'm a big shot, homie. Shows vicious in my prime. Venus boys, cities boys. I show you the price of crime. Avoid the casualties. We gotta cash out. I'm gonna disconnect the battery now. No, it like what? Just need to disconnect the negative, right? That's my concern.
I just don't have to take, you want to take up the
whole thing, that's true.
bastards. Race to the top, faster. Paul Walker to these bastards. With Sam O, the sword shot like we fencing with fences. To a mention, it's a lynching, and the rope came from Spencer's. Let it be known, I'm judicial with underage instrumentals. Ray Baddeley in my mental, reading yours like broken candles. Currency seen the crypt, protect the vision like an eye guard. Slave to the script, I cry guard if I'm a diehard. Mistake is managed, the kids in my suits fill us. Cause I'd rather go Bruce Willis than let the noose kill us. Monarch with the malarkey, thirsty thoughts, posh, just possibly broke her smartly plan. Cause they slept with Beatles, Paul McCartney. Accent it lacks, in it rotten, lowest gas, spinach, data fire, don't spit it, hacks, get it, accent it, swallow myths. Like kids see the tooth fairy, cause the crew scared. If the price is right, then I'll paint a sight, horror flicks, and I Drew Carey.
Bye. Bye. Bye, everybody. Yay.
Bye.